Hello, internet friend. Hi, Def.
High five.
Last episode, we returned to the 1990s, the decade where Mario got a movie and Luigi took over Iraq. We learned it was a decade of hope and cynicism. Star Trek had a black leader 18 years before America, and Professor X was hearty and fit until his terrible accident. We learned the rules that made the decade go round. Rule number one, only smart people are evil. Rule number two, everything's a sequel or about to get a sequel. And we checked out the first of our 10 games that summed up the 1990s, the decade where if you weren't cool, you were dead, and even being dead could be kinda cool. But now it's time to meet the top five, so buckle those rollerblades, slap on a slap band, snap into a Slim Jim, and eat all the Pop-Tarts you can. Here's
the top 10 most 90s video games, part 2.
Number 5!
With Sonic running wild and Mario keeping pace, you couldn't move in the 90s for game studio mascots who were cute enough for the kids, but bad enough dudes to rescue the president. Usually they were Sonic clones. Havoc was a seal with a sword, Rocket Knight was a possum with a sword and a jetpack, Zool was an intergalactic gremlin ninja who killed a blue hedgehog, Aero the Acrobat was why you don't leave puns where kids can find them, Bubsy was just shit, Gex told jokes, and once everything went 3D, we got Crash Bandicoot, whose orange fur, jeans, and happy dumbness gave these pricks a role model.
Number 4.
Released for the Genesis in 1993, Skitchen scores high on the 90s-ometer thanks to its soundtrack, unnecessary abbreviation. Rule 3 of the 90s. If the word ain't cool enough, drop the G at the end. Yeah. Skitchen! Skitchen! And the fact that you're a punk hitting people with crowbars while holding the back bumpers of cars while wearing rollerblades. Suck it, GTA 5!
Number 3.
Cool Spot makes it onto this list for being the most cynical corporate idea ever turned into a video game. Other company mascots had a go. Chester Cheetah, the Cheetos Cheetah, had Chester Cheetah Too Cool to Fool, and Ronald McDonald was the only clown allowed near children since Stephen King wrote It. But Cool Spot wasn't just a pre-existing mascot thrown into the world of games. Cool Spot was the dot on the 7-Up bottle, but given sunglasses and a slot on the Super Nintendo. 90s rule number 4. If it ain't cool enough, add sunglasses. They said jammin' when they meant good and bogus when they meant bad. One was an alien dressed as Flavor Flav, the other looked like John Goodman crossed with the yellow M&M. Trapped on planet Earth till they find the parts of their broken spaceship, these intergalactic rappers... 90s rule 5. If it's not a ninja, it has to be a rapper. And if it's a rapper, it's either a rapper from space, a rapper who's involved in gang warfare, or both. These intergalactic rappers roam around doing battle with stereotypes of suburban life, like flocks of nerds, evil dentists, sinister lawnmowers, and a demon that got away from you in Doom. Notable for having a leveling up system where you start off as a wiener and move all the way up to Funk Lord. That's right. Funk Lord. What a German name. Toe Jam and Earl was all that was bitching and righteous about the early 90s. The list is nearly done, let's recap. Number 10, Sonic the Hedgehog and his mysterious finger. Number 9, Doom 2. Number 8, TV and movie platform games. Number 7, Mortal Kombat. Number 6, the most obscure entry on the list, Rise of the Triad. Number 5, Pantless Lizardy Batty Rocket Crash Gremlin Space Ninja 2, Rise of the Ripoffs. Number 4, Badasses Wear Colourful Clothes and Sensible Elbow Pads in Skitchen. Number 3, Put the Glasses On, It's Done, Cool Spot. Number 2, Toe Jam and Earl.
Number 1.
Blood? Check. Guns? Check. Attitude?
Let's rock.
Check. Space? Check. Sunglasses? Check. Sequel? Check. Boobs? What? The most 90s game of all is none other than Duke Nukem 3D. Originally a mild side-scrolling parody of 80s and 90s action heroes, by 1996 the Duke had a jetpack and a rocket launcher and multiplayer and pipe bombs and a shrink ray and a freeze ray and the cops were pigs and you could piss in the toilet. And if this wasn't enough, you could go to the strip club and look at young ladies and murder everyone in there, but that's okay because the game would punish you by spawning more enemies. Sorry, did I say punish? I meant give you more things to kill, which is kind of the point of the game. I was 11 when the Jukester came out, and I remember the first thing someone said to me was, "Look, if you press spacebar, you can see her boobs." The next thing they said to me was, "If you press A, he can jump," since both were new at the time. I suppose statistically I spent more time jumping, but I remember what was more interesting. It's not like I had to wait for my mum to not be around so I could jump. You could say it's a parody of the cheesiness and misogyny of 90s action movies, but you know it's not a parody. It's a funny, over-the-top, exploitative, immature, crass, violent, fun game that rampages through the street, grinning and joking and mowing everybody down with an automatic weapon before cracking open a beer, cracking onto a girl, and crapping down an alien's neck. And if that's not a good metaphor for gaming in the 90s, I don't know what is. Your winner and still champion, Duke Nukem 3D. That is that list done. Like, share, and subscribe so I can put my imaginary kids through imaginary school. You've been lovely. See ya.